All right. Hello, 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 ladies, and welcome to today's success interview with Pamela J. Oaks. Thank you so much for joining us, Pamela.
Absolutely. Glad to be here.
I'm so grateful. We were just talking a minute ago about how Zoom has just changed our lives in the last few weeks. So I'm just grateful for technology. So I'm just checking on my phone. We are indeed live. So we are really here to give some inspiration and some motivation to all of the women entrepreneurs who are building their businesses online during this time. I mean, any time of the year, it's always like, what do I sell? What are people going to buy? You know, what's my brand? What content do I post? Like all that stuff. Those are always questions that are going on in our minds any time of the year. But during this taping of this interview, we are in the middle of a coronavirus pandemic and everyone is freaking out about what's going to happen with their business. So the good news is that I know quite a few women in our tribe who are crushing it with their business, with their sales, yes. And Pamela is one of them. So we're just going to dive right in to give you all the goodies. And I'm going to first just ask Pamela to share a little bit about herself. Pamela is a former client of mine. I should say, you know, you've been around so, you know, I mean, it's so long. It's like client for life. But Pamela has an amazing business and I'll just let her tell you a little bit about it. So Pamela, can you tell everybody, what do you do?
Sure. Well, my business name is The Profitable Nonprofit, and I am a nonprofit fund development expert. So fund development is different than fundraising. Fundraising is that, you know, that transactional activity or event, sell tickets, get money. But fund development is actually the strategy that goes behind how to locate and identify funding sources, how to cultivate and nurture those funding partnerships and collaborations. And also it's about organizational development so that once you find the money, how you qualify to get it. So I do all of those things. And yes, fundraising is part of that. Grant writing is part of that. That's all part of my background, but that's what I do. And I love doing that. I really do.
I love it.
Empower those organizations who are, especially now, on the front lines, trying to help people and making sure that everybody is doing okay during this crazy time.
Yeah, I mean, it's one of those things where it's like, it's a service that's so needed. And I know a lot of the ladies watching and listening, they have a service that's very needed, but a lot of times it's hard to be aware of that when there's so much going on that could prevent your clients from investing. So that's what I want to talk about. So we know what you do. And so now I want to know, what do you sell? Like, what types of packages, offers, programs are you offering your clients?
Right. Well, so I do a variety of things, which I learned from you. I do private.
Multiple revenue streams.
And honestly, that is the key. That's why I'm so busy right now. This is a busy time for me. And that is exactly why, because I took the time to develop my revenue streams. I do private coaching. I do group coaching. I just finished one of my first group coaching courses, which was fantastic. And I do workshops, I do seminars. And because I am, my background is in nonprofits, and that's what I do and have been my entire career, corporate and entrepreneurial. So now I'd even have packages put together so I can sell my services and my expertise to ongoing corporate clients. So I do it all: workshops, seminars, conferences, speaking. I do keynotes. I do it all. And that is really the key. So even though, you know, one area might be down and the other might be up, and that's the key to sustainability and that diversifying those revenue streams, multiple revenue streams. Absolutely.
Yes. I want to dig into that a little bit more because when we started working together last year, I know that the online piece was something that you wanted to build out, and just it's so timely to share with the ladies right now, given what we're going through. What was your experience with adding an online revenue stream? I know that you're used to working with clients in person, doing your in-person speaking and all that. Like, what was it like for you to have that experience in building it out? And then how does it feel now on the other side, having this online course you can sell anytime?
Right. It was terrifying and nerve-wracking. To be honest, I am, as you know, I'm old school. I prefer human interaction, whether I'm speaking, getting with people, that old school way of picking up the phone and calling people. So, right. Okay, I've been dragged and pushed into the 21st century. But honestly, I am so glad. I have been talking about it for so long. Once I got it up and I think the anxiety was because I didn't know the technology and I didn't know how it worked. And so I felt like it was out of my control. Okay, probably a little control freak there. And so I'm like, I don't know how that works. And so I didn't know what to do. Yeah. What do? You find somebody who does know what to do. I paid somebody to help me put that together instead of dragging it out and going in all these, you know, in my head about and all this time. It's like, just pay somebody to do it and get it done, which I did, got it done. And it was a lot simpler than I thought, which means I could probably do it myself now that I know. But now that I got the sales page up there, got all the, you know, all the automations and everything. And I'm so glad because since my particular business was so heavily focused on private clients, that was taking up a lot of my time. I knew that in order to grow and expand, I had to have an online component so that I could make up that some of that revenue all at once in a group. I could not continue to sustain just doing private clients. And so yeah. I am so, so glad that I finally got that up and running and it's done. And so much easier than I thought, kind of kicking myself that I didn't do it, you know, last year when I first started thinking about it, but yeah. It's done now, right?
Right. I mean, that's what matters. It's better late than never. You know what I mean? Like we've been to multiple retreats and working through, but you know, sometimes good things do take time. And when it's out there, though, now you have an asset for your business that you can just launch over and over again whenever you want.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And the other thing, again, kind of going along with that multiple revenue streams is that my private clients, that was the high end client. Mm-hmm. Right. And so I didn't have that lower end offering that could really bring in more clients. Most of the people who want to work with me, they're like, OK, let me get back to you after I save the money or whatever, which was fine. But I want to have kind of an easier entry point for people to work with me. And so that's what this was. So, so glad that I have it up and running now, which was fantastic.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Yeah. I mean, I always tell people, you know, start with high end, you know, get that going first so you can get the big bucks into your business bank account, and then work on your low end offer. So I love that you do both. And I know that the question in everyone's mind, knowing the ideal client that you work with, nonprofits, a lot of people think, you know, they don't have any money and all of that. So the six figure question, if you will, would be what have you done? Like what type of marketing or content or whatever have you done to attract like your high-end clients to come and want to work with you?
And it's really interesting because that's the first thing. Oh, there's no money in nonprofits. But the thing about it is, and I think I got this from you as well, is I don't have to work with every nonprofit out there. I only have to work with the ones who are called to me. And the ones who are called to me need me. And they are attracted to what I have and what I sell. And so what I know about all nonprofits is that they're always looking for money. And so that's where I focus my services. I focus on, you need some money, talk to me, let's work it out. Let's get a strategy in place. That's what they all need. Uh-huh. And so in that sense,
it was targeting what they want and what they need.
Absolutely. And it's really interesting because since this is my background, even from the corporate world, what I know about qualifying for funding is that sometimes it's not the things that you're focused on. Lots of times it's organizational structure, infrastructure, leadership, development, and all that, which is the reason you don't get the money. And what I find is that you have to sell people what they want.
Yes.
But what they need.
Exactly.
Because, you know, people are just like, just, I don't want all the development. I don't want you to do all, just tell me, where do I need to go to find that money? And you know, obviously I could give you that list, but you won't qualify for it because right. there's so many other things that determine that. So, cause at first, I think when I first started out, I was trying to give people what they needed, yes. which was all the development and everything. And I'm like, how come nobody's just picking up on this? It's because nobody is thinking if they want, nobody wants that. So then I'm just, hey, let's just sell the money part of it, right?
Yeah.
All of a sudden that just kind of opened it up because then everybody's like, I want this. It's really funny. I was doing a webinar just the other day, again, because this local organization having their membership together and they want to know some contingency fundraising in this coronavirus, right? So they had to come on and it was fascinating. I'm looking through the list and there were small organizations, but there was huge nonprofits on this call listening to see what are you going to say? Mm-hmm. And what I realized is that it doesn't matter, big or small, everybody, every nonprofit, all my clients want to know where's the money and how do I get it? So yes. that's what I focus on. My messaging is always that, but mm-hmm. in messaging, once they work with me, then that's when the time that I can work out, okay, but let's work on this as well to make sure that once we find this money, you can qualify for it mm-hmm. and that you can build that muscle. So it was really interesting, you know, selling what they want, but giving them what they need.
Yes, that is probably the biggest nugget. Like that is a six-figure strategy right there
yes.
that I've used in my entire business. And what a lot of people, especially my life coaches, my mindset coaches, they're like, I want to help them to, you know, release their emotional trauma. And it's going to be very deep and involved. Like nobody wants to be miserable for 3 months while they're releasing their emotional trauma. Like what do they want on the other side of that? Like if they want a man, say you're going to help them get a man. If they want to raise money, say that you're going to help them raise money. If they want to get a new job, say that, you know, and that's one of the reasons why people have a hard time selling. So your level of mastery in this has really, you know, exploded your brand online. And it's been just amazing to watch you from when we first had our VIP dinner back in like San Diego years ago to now. You're like one of the go-to funding experts, you know, in the country. So I would just have you highlight, like, what would you say is like the number one or two things that you've learned throughout the time that we worked together, the top things that stood out to you?
Right. One of the top things that I learned from you was really how to package what I sell. And I remember thinking when I first started out, I had this one service that I was going to offer. And I knew, I saw these, you know, especially like you had all these different packages, all these different programs. And I remember thinking, how do you get all those different programs? I do this one thing. What programs am I going to offer, right? Mm-hmm. And the way of thinking how to just repackage what I do, maybe in smaller chunks, bigger chunks, or however that is, to meet the needs of the clients where they are. So one of the reasons that as I had posted, which I think got your attention, was I had a huge month. I mean, like a $50,000 client. And people are like, oh my gosh, well, how did you do that? How did you get that? And it was doing exactly what I'm doing, but just packaging it in a different way. And so usually where I work with one-on-one with, say, the executive director, I said, well, why don't I put this package together? I can work one-on-one with the executive. Oh, but then I'll throw in a couple trainings for a couple of your top directors. Oh, then maybe I'll do a little volunteer training. Oh, and then I'll put together this strategy. Oh, and then maybe I'll, you know, and I just built this little package around exactly what I knew that they needed. And again, kind of goes back to the discovery call. So how to package what my services are. And so I'm not necessarily creating something entirely new. I'm just repackaging and reformatting exactly what I do. That was key for me because I kept thinking, how do I develop a new trick, a new skill, a new, like I do one thing. Right. So what do you mean? Get another program. What does that mean? So,
right.
And that helped me so, so much. The other thing that I absolutely love, and it's not something necessarily that you taught me, but it was key for my business and that you provide space for this, is accountability. Oh my gosh. For anybody who's going to be in business, you have to hang around other people who are doing the exact same thing you are, because it's those conversations and that energy that could spark a new idea for you. Totally. If you just are going to get that, or hanging around people who aren't in business. And so that's what I loved. That's why I always just keep going to your masterminds, and, you know, we've traveled all over the world. Yes. Is because I love, there's nothing that can compare to being in a group of entrepreneurs who are all on the same path, going after the same thing. And so I have stayed in contact with many of the, couple of top accountability partners for me. We check in every week or every month.
Right.
To make sure that we are on track for our business. That is key. Yeah. Somebody has to hold you accountable to say, you said you were going to do this. Are you still doing this? Because life happens, you know, especially if you have a home-based business and you're, you know, it's so easy to just go sit on the couch and watch TV, you know, like, oh man, I should be making calls right now or something. Right. You have to, it's great to have goals, but you have to be accountable to those goals.
Right.
And that other thing that I got from you, which I love about you, why I followed you for so long, is your authenticity. Mm-hmm. When I got into this, I thought, well, I'll be a consultant. And there's a reason I call myself an expert and not a consultant. Mm-hmm. And it puts you in a box. People have this preconceived idea of what consultants do, right? And I'm like, no, I can do whatever I want. This is my business. Not look like any other consultant out there. So it's funny now that I have people that I used to work with, you know, in the corporate world, and they're like, what are you doing? How did you get this? How did you get that client? And because in that there's that mindset, this is what a consultant does, and you're not doing that. So right. What are you doing? And that's great. I am me. I'm doing what I like to do, how I like to do it. And
you're getting paid very well for it.
Yes. And the confidence of knowing that, that people respond to that. And one thing about that, which is, you had made a post a while ago too. It's like, if you are, it was something about getting the money you want. And you said, like, it's just like really easy. It's like you double your prices and you make more money. And there is always that fear of where are these clients going to come from? And again, you have to trust to know. I don't, you know, some people look at my prices and like, there's no way I would pay her. Great. Not my client. There's other people who are like, what a great deal. And you have to have the confidence of knowing that those clients are out there.
And so good.
Mm-hmm.
So good. I mean, I always look at other industries, and people always say, well, how much should I charge? And should I charge what this person is charging? And I'm like, no, why would you take on their money mindset? Just because they don't think they're worth a $50,000 contract doesn't mean that you have to take that on. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
Heads and shoulders above your peers. Not that we're in competition, because no one can compete with us. We're, you know, there's only one us, but it's important to get out of that, like, traditional, even from the business world, traditional, mm-hmm. Here's how we do it. Here's how much you typically charge and all that. Like, you get to write your own check and do whatever you want to do.
Absolutely. I think so many people are like, oh, let me just do some research online and Google what are the typical salaries for consultants doing this. And I don't fit that box. You know, I just decided this is what I do. And if you want, and this is what it will cost you.
Yes.
And, you know, and there's a thing about also that, and I know you believe in this, is that that abundance mindset, because that's key for an entrepreneur. And somebody told me this once, and I've never forgotten it. It's if you are standing in a river and there's water flowing, you can take as much water in out with a bucket. You can fill up that bucket as many times as you want in that river. You will never lower the river, right? There's always more coming.
Always more. I love that.
That's that abundant mindset. It's like, it's not like, oh, if I take this and somebody else is not going to have this. It's not a pie. It's a river. You can stand in the river and take out as much as you want. You can take out bucket. You can take out a pool size. You can take out from that river as much abundance as you want, but you have to believe that you can, that it's there for you. Yes. Because mind that keeps you from it. I think for when I first started out, I almost subconsciously was going after smaller clients because subconsciously I was more comfortable. I knew I'd do a great job for them. And I thought, well, if I go for these bigger clients, then if I make a mistake, then they'll think I'm not qualified. And right. That was all in my head.
All in your mind. Yes.
All in my head. And then I realized it's like, wait a minute, you know, it's like, this is, I'm going to offer what I do to anybody and everybody, whether
right.
there's
who's going to say you can't, right? It's your thing. It's your business. You can do whatever yes. you want. I feel like that's right. like, if I ever got a tattoo, which I wouldn't because I'm a scaredy cat, but it would be like, I can do whatever I want like on my arm. We exactly. have such freedom in our businesses.
Yes.
And when you take advantage of that, your income just, there's no ceiling.
Absolutely. And when you can get, let yourself out of the box, then it just opens up just a whole realm of opportunities. And part of that, again, like I say, is you have to surround yourself with people who are also in the middle of thinking creatively, because right. I've been on the phone with people like my accountability partners, and they'll say something. I'm like, oh my gosh, that's a fantastic idea. I need to see how to implement that in my business. But had I not been talking to them, you know, had we been talking about The Bachelor or Survivor or some other reality TV show, never would have gotten those creative ideas. That
right.
only comes from hanging out with people who are doing what you're doing and going where you're trying to go.
Exactly. I love this. So many nuggets. I'm just watching the live feed in our group. People are loving the analogy of the river. Oh, that is so good. So many takeaways that people can use in their business just from what you shared here today, Pamela. I'm so grateful. And I know that actually a lot of my ladies also have a nonprofit or are involved with a nonprofit in their world. So I know that some people want to connect with you on that angle. So I'd love for you just to share before we close how people can get connected to you, how they can book a call with you, if they need help with their funding and anything else with their nonprofit. How can they find you?
Absolutely. I am all over social media, thanks to Rosetta Thurman. So I have a website. My website is profitable-nonprofit.com. Mm-hmm. And if you go there, you can connect with me through there. I am on Facebook. I'm Pamela J. Oakes, O-A-K-E-S, on Facebook. And I'm also on Instagram under the Profitable MP. And and also on LinkedIn. And under LinkedIn, just under my name as well. So people can connect with me anywhere. And for those people, if I could just say a quick thing for people who do have nonprofits, I've been getting, again, a lot of my clients saying, well, in this time, should we just hold off on our fundraising? Should we just scale back and wait till it all passes? And I say, when money is tight, that's when you need to scale up, not scale back. This is the time to do your fundraising, to do all of that. And for nonprofits, you're on the front lines anyway. People are looking to you to have answers. So this yeah. is the time for you to dive in. This is the time that we're made for nonprofits. So
right.
if you're still thinking about opening business, you need to open it right now, because people are looking for people who have answers. So
if there was any time, it would be now. It's like, why would you shrink in a time when so many people need you? Whether it's a nonprofit or in your business, it's time for all of us to step up, level up. And the ones who are left standing
yes.
are going to be the leaders who, you know, rose to the occasion. And so I love that you do that. I love that you push your clients. You don't just give them the tactics and the strategies, but you also push them to their next level of greatness. And that is
yes.
one of the things that I definitely admire about you.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it. And then for you, what I love is that I remember I always tried to get out of you a formula. Just tell me the process. And you're like, there isn't one. Just do it. And that's so key. I think a lot of women entrepreneurs are like, what business should I start? Or what can I do? What is the formula on how to do this? And it's just start, because you and I both know I'm so thankful I know how to generate income in a time when every other business is closed. I'm sitting in my house still making money because I have learned how to generate money. And that's a skill that will never go out of style.
Exactly. If you know how to make money, you will never be broke.
Never be broke. Because I can always go back and get a job if I wanted to.
Right.
But, but knowing how to generate money, that's priceless.
It is so priceless and so good. So many great nuggets you've shared with us. I so appreciate you taking the time to be here. And I'm going to put all of your links in the show notes for those listening on the podcast so they can connect with you. Again, I just really want to lift up those who are in our tribe, who are really doing the work and walking the talk and being a good example, a shining light that people can look up to and people can learn from. So I know that a lot of ladies will be looking to you and taking your nuggets of advice and putting them to practice in their business. So thank you again, Pamela, for being on the show, and I'll talk to you soon.
Great. Thanks a lot.
Bye, everyone.